Day. His service dog, Sully, faithfully joining his companion on the final journey.
Sully was named after the pilot who successfully landed the plane in the Hudson. The Yellow Lab has performed some miracles of his own, and he began his life on Long Island. TV 1055's Jennifer McLogan reports.
His full name, Sully H.W. Bush, born and raised on Long Island, faithfully waiting at the casket of President George H.W. Bush. The caption reads, "Mission complete."
But you saw that picture, you know, that the president's team posted yesterday, and you just got chills.
Chills for sure in Smithtown. It was here where Sully was trained by America's Vet Dogs, presented to the 41st president shortly after the death of his wife, Barbara. He tweeted then, "A great joy to welcome home the newest member of our family, Sully, a beautiful and beautifully trained lab. Training service dogs like Sully requires multiple months of classes here, spread over 10 acres in Smithtown." Many of these dogs grew up with Sully.
Give. Oh, good boy. Get him.
Yes. Brad Hibbard, among those who brought Sully to the Bush's summer home in Kennebunkport, Maine last June, offering the president companionship and support at his time of grief.
We introduced Sully to all of the different pet dogs that were there at the compound, and all of the family met the dog. We spent a week there working with President Bush and his team.
Sully will return to Long Island at the end of the week and reside here until after the holidays, then be placed at Walter Reed National Medical Facility to work with wounded U.S. veterans.
And as you look at, you know, the service that Sully provided to the president, you know, we have great pride, but you know, we're all very sad as well.
Those close to the service dog say, for now, Sully appears lonely, loyal to the U.S. leader for whom he had unwavering allegiance. From Smithtown, Long Island, Jennifer McLogan, TV 1055.
Poor Sully, but vet dog leaders say Sully is getting his spirit back and will share his love for life with wounded vets after the president's funeral beginning next month.